We have reviewed hundreds of smartphones on Gadgets 360, and one of the most common questions we get in the comment section on YouTube is, can it play PUBG Mobile? While most smartphones are now powerful enough to play the game, some of the more affordable ones struggle and the experience isn't always enjoyable. Tencent Games recently launched a less resource-hungry version of the game called PUBG Mobile Lite, aimed at entry-level smartphones. It is just 491 MB in size, so it shouldn't be a problem even if you buy the base variant of a smartphone. But how low can you go? Which is the least expensive smartphone to play PUBG Mobile Lite on? And will it be a good experience? Well, we are about to find out. PUBG Mobile Lite uses lower graphics settings, has just one map, Erangel, and is limited to 60 players per map, so you will not get much variety here. There are only two servers for PUBG Mobile Lite, one in South America and the other in Asia. This means that if you live far from these locations, you can expect longer pings and a less than ideal gaming experience. Those are the basic things you need to know about PUBG Mobile Lite. Now let's get our testing started. The Redmi Go is the lowest priced smartphone we had in our test lab, costing 4,499 rupees. It runs Google's optimized Android Go software and has just 1 GB of RAM and 8 GB of storage. There's only around 4.6 GB of free space on the Redmi Go after you set it up. That's why PUBG Mobile Lite's relatively manageable 491 MB install size is great for this smartphone. We also didn't have to uninstall any apps on the Redmi Go to play PUBG Mobile Lite. We were honestly surprised that the Redmi Go could load the game, even though it took a lot longer than we expected. It took close to 1 minute and 16 seconds to load the game. There's no way to change the graphics settings on PUBG Mobile Lite, so we played it at the default settings. And the default settings on PUBG Mobile Lite is even lower than the lowest setting on PUBG Mobile. The draw distance is also low on PUBG Mobile Lite, so you will see objects and textures loading as you approach them. This doesn't affect gameplay that much, but it's still an important difference to note. It's comparatively easier to spot enemies while playing PUBG Mobile Lite because of the way they've represented it on the minimap. You can see the exact location from where the bullet was fired on the minimap in this game, as opposed to seeing just the direction from where the bullet was fired in the regular one. We noticed occasional stutter while playing, and we did see some texture popping on the device. It also had a mild input lag. The game was still playable though, and it wasn't a frustrating experience. We survived one full round, after which the phone was slightly warm to the touch, but not unbearable. After playing the game for 20 minutes, we noticed a 9% battery drain. The audio was also in sync while playing PUBG Mobile Lite on the Redmi Go. Now, this wasn't the case when we were playing regular PUBG Mobile on underpowered smartphones. This means that this particular game is optimized for low-end devices. We were happy with the fact that the game was playable on a smartphone that cost just 4,499 rupees and had only 1 GB of RAM. However, it wasn't the best to experience PUBG Mobile Lite on, as there were still occasional stutters. We played this game on other low-end smartphones as well, and the MediaTek Helio A22 managed to perform quite well. This particular processor is also powering other smartphones like the Redmi 6A and the Nokia 2.2, which are available around the 6,000 and 7,000 rupee price point. So that was the gaming experience of PUBG Mobile Lite on the most affordable smartphone. Now, what do you guys think about this? Let us know in the comment section down below. And as always, for all things tech, stay tuned to Gadgets360.com.